say hi. I'm a dog passionate man. Yeah. So what I do is nafanya busy art na pia I do side line with dogs. So the side of dog business since I was small, as in I was young, nimekuwa I've lived the life of a dog lover. So back then nikiwa huko nikiwa mdogo ucha nilipenda sana even the local dog. So I was very passionate. Second year in campus, nilisave help yangu nikanunua my first German Shepherd, a purebred dog. And let's say from 2016 now I started serious my dog business. The business part inakuja after the passion part. So it is out of kupenda mbwa that you can run a dog business. So first by loving the dogs, then you start the business. First, you need the capital. In my second year, that's when I got the chance to accumulate enough amount to buy a pure dog. I bought it at 21,000, a puppy at 6 months. For the German Shepherd, the first one, I was from a friend who was breeding. I was back in campus. I raised until 2019. I bought it. Then from there, I started the art business. From Apple, don't me accumulate now the amount good enough to buy the small breeds, the Maltese na the Boer Bay. So currently there are 3 dogs mature. So nikona the Maltese, the small one, na mostly wanaitanga Chihuahua. Then nikona South African Boer Bay, yeah, and the German Shepherd. Basically, the dog business is a good business. Profit wise, it's good. You kiangalia the cost of bringing up a dog. Now maybe with proper breeding, that you are the stages, maybe breeding ya mbwa it follows a certain procedure. So ukimake kufuata the process, a dog like a South African Boer Bay, the current one, this year on August ilikuwa na 14 puppies. But normally with the breeding in a side at least 10 puppies. So like with 10 puppies na soko ya Boer Bay, it's a good business. Like each puppy, a Boer Bay puppy each goes for 40,000 and above. Raising a Boer Bay for 1 year from being a puppy, then breeding it for the next 2 months, then getting 14 puppies or even 10, then that's a good job. Currently, due to the network enye mtu kama mimi niko nayo, it's a local market. So mostly have friends, niko na page Facebook, all dog lovers, you find that people who follow that group, a small percentage wako na uwezo ya kununua the dogs. Others, from my station, wherever I do my art, those people who love art are ni watu wanapenda like the luxury things, and there are people who can really afford a puppy. So basically, soko yangu ya dogs ni my clients who buy art, most of them, and hii soko ingine ni ya through referrals, maybe from the people who love dogs. I can say Ebu County has really supported us. You first from building the capital, nimesema I was doing art. Ebu County imekuwa ikisupport art, like seriously. Artists like kuna customers, wana create avenues kama show. So from there, you build the contact. Then after hapo ndo unapata like now those people you who are selling art, you can now easily convince them to buy dogs, and you have time to convince them to show them hiyo ni ya mbwa. Okay, a dog is like man's best friend. For example, this is a dog, it may chill up with new people and it's very calm. Those people are afraid of dogs, you need to have a dog that, as in you select, dogs have characters, ni kama tu binadamu. Kuna security dogs, kuna companion dogs, kuna others very lazy dogs. They just need you, and in fact, akina Labradors, they are very cool dogs. So basically, people who fear dogs, maybe they fear them because of the bite. One thing for you to raise any dog or any animal, it must be up to date in health yake. For your health to be good, the dog's health must be good. So basically, what you do, like a dog, the dog must be vaccinated. Like in Aqua, you have to be updated on the vaccines. So like vaccine in the first 3 months, unaidunga the DHLP vaccine. Make sure the dog is rabies vaccine up to date. Like after every 6 months, ikiwa mdogo, 6 months inadunga the first rabies. Then repeat that after every 1 year. To the youths, there is a lot to do. Right. Basically, me nikimalizana my art business. Once I'm from my station, I come to attending my dogs. Basically, during the day, the dog feeds once a day. So during that time of feeding, though, you, before feeding, take it through some training refreshment. When I refresh the training, then you feed the dog. So basically, youth, maybe if at all you can't own a dog, you can opt to be a trainer. Get time, many people are owning dogs, but their dogs are, maybe come and training in a train for a few days, the trainer leaves. But dogs need the fresher training. So if at all to get one youths from around, when they can be taken through refresher courses that training dogs. During their free time in the evening, just 2 hours, go talk to people with dogs, make sure they have your trust, and maybe they can offer a chance. Dog, a purebred dog, pedigree, you need almost 50,000 for a starter. Like you need a good kennel, come on, the big dogs. You need good feeding. You have to be strict on the diet. If a dog really feeds for 1 year, then from there you can get puppies. In 1 year you can get, let's say, for example this one, the small breeds, they mature at 6 months. So within 6 months, the first 3 months feeding will cost you not more than I think 10,000 the first 6 months, that is to maturity. Then the next 3 months, so that you give it a chance to at least mature sexually for breeding, 3 months, 4 months, it will feed almost, let's say, another 20,000. Then after breeding, during breeding, you will get maybe, let's say, 5 puppies for the first lot. So 5 puppies, if you sell each at 40,000, then you get the value for your money. I took it to myself that I really needed to know more about dogs. Like, how are dogs bred? Like, at what stage do you breed your dogs? How do you train a dog? How do you live with a purebred dogs? Knowing the characteristic of each and every dog, like ujue mbwa wako, like you don't just go, now you have money, you go buy a dog. So you have to know which dog really fits what you want. Like ukifanya, ukianza biashara ya boar bell, it's a large breed, heavy feeder. Do you have the right amount of money to feed it until it gets back to profit? But for the small breeds, you just need a small. So for a startup, if you start with a small breed, then you can graduate to even buying a bigger breed. Because once you get the puppies, from there you have accumulated enough. So basically, by learning the characters of a dog, to the youths out there, there are businesses in Kenya, but jobs, there are really few jobs. So a business is easy to start, because one thing, you become your own boss and it's easier to manage your cash. Again, in business, you dictate what you want at the end. If you want higher profit, then you add extra energy, like you do extra effort. if you really don't work, then you expect either little profit or zero. So basically, for a business, it's easier to start a business, however small. Like for an art business, you just need few materials. With little input, then you can get a better profit. So basically, starting a business is way better. And dog breeding, one thing, it's the best thing anybody could do. You get profit from your best friend. Dog breeding, once you get a dog, you have really got a, like, it's the best friend. Atakuwa hapo na wewe. If you are living with a security dog, it's your security. Once it gets puppies, it will never ask you for 10%. Like, this was my kid. The dog will just give you puppies, raise the puppies to the desired time. As long as you're taking care of it, then you are assured of profit. So you take care of your best friend, and your best friend gives you profit at zero cost. Yeah, so basically dog breeding is good. And youths, people really need to come to this business. Again, these days, everywhere in Kenya, real estate is growing. People are building. People need, every homestead needs a security dog. Every homestead needs an ornamental dog, not really a security dog. Beautiful houses coming up. So there is a big gap that we need to fit. And if at all we get as many breeders in this industry, then the market will be sufficient.